feel the shot, I said, oh, I'm gonna die. I mean, that was my thing.
Byron walked up to the unit he thought he was supposed to paint, knocked three times.
Well, I was announcing myself too, every time that I knocked.
And on the third time, the man inside opened the door and shot him.
I just saw a light.
The light from the gun?
From the gun and the loud noise from the shot.
The bullet went into his chest and out his side.
This much from the heart to hit the heart.
Miraculously, he was able to stumble to his truck, drive to the front office to get help.
The gentleman who's been shot is on our living room couch. He is. He's on the phone, I think, with his wife.
You get it to the point that, well, this is it. And I want to make sure that I say goodbye to my kids. I want to make sure that they hear me, that I love them.
Byron says it's by the grace of God that he was able to pull through.
One point is life and the other one is death. And I was in between. And for some reason, God got me here for a reason.
He's now back home in his recliner, surrounded by family, with a new perspective on life and a new mission.
Go to places, go to the churches, and proclaim that God is good.
And he says that he is also thankful that he's able to build on the relationship that he's been able to have with his kids and walk them through this time, because he has been praying and has forgiven the man who shot him and has prayed for him, but he is still frustrated that no charges were ever filed against him. To this day, he tells me that he and his wife have never been given a reason as to why that is.
Yeah, best wishes for him.